Sound design.
All right, so we're continuing in our process here to build our own cheap or free DIY two-channel audio analyzer so we can run Smaart or SATlive or SysTune or whatever. And we already talked about shopping for a microphone. So if you don't know which microphone to get, go back and watch those videos. We already talked about shopping for an audio interface. So if you don't know which audio interface to use, go back and watch those videos. Now we're gonna talk about which software should I get? And this is a big question for people and sometimes kind of a roadblock, kind of a stumbling block, because this is where you might start to consider investing in some money.
Anybody who invests their money in Bitcoin is stupid.
You might not have this piece of software just lying around your house, but I'm gonna show you that you can get started with even a free option and that's not gonna slow you down at all. Does it matter which piece of software we get? Again, just like the other pieces, in the end, it doesn't really matter. It's just a tool that helps us get to our end goal, which is making better sound. It's just a tool that delivers data. They all kind of do the same thing. The only requirement is that whatever software you choose needs to be able to take a two-channel measurement and create a transfer function. And again, a transfer function is just the process of comparing an input to an output so that we can see that if we send a bicycle out, that we get a bicycle back. Or how is it different? And therefore, if it's different, what sort of changes do we need to make? Are we gonna make changes? What choices will we make depending on that, okay? Or maybe it doesn't come back as a bicycle, it comes back as a rocket ship, and then there might be a problem and we need to look into that. Can you use the RTA app on your phone? No, that is a single channel measurement. It doesn't tell time, compute polarity. It's not very helpful for the kind of work that we need to do. What we've got are some platform considerations. If you're on a Mac, probably the way to go is Smaart, okay? It's one of the most common pieces of software. It has a big community worldwide. There are education opportunities. If you get stuck on something, you can probably find someone who can help you out pretty quickly. Now, if you're on a PC, you can also choose SATlive. And this is the piece of software that I used exclusively for the first 10 years of my career doing measurements. I initially chose it just because of the price tag. I didn't even have a PC. I had to install Bootcamp on my Mac and then, you know, jump through some other hoops. But it is a little bit cheaper than the cheapest version of Smaart, only runs on PC. Okay, so keep that in mind. You'll need a Windows machine. There is a free alternative though. Now, I used to recommend Room EQ Wizard, and I know a lot of people use that with success. In fact, I have a student right now who's been using it for 6 years, and he's great at it. My only problem with Room EQ Wizard is that it doesn't quite look the same as these others. Smaart, SATlive, and Rita, the interface, all look pretty much the same. And what that means for you is that you can get started using this free option, Rita, from Educasound, and then when you're ready to upgrade, you can get SATlive and basically train yourself to use the slightly different interface in an evening, you know? And then if you wanna upgrade to Smaart, same thing. You can basically train yourself just how the controls work a little bit differently. But again, it's the same data, it looks the same. I just tested it and it now runs on this Mac that I'm using right now, which has the latest operating system. So that's great news. It doesn't limit you. It also runs on PC. Okay, so I don't have a lot of experience with Room EQ Wizard, but I heard recently that the team who was out on tour with this band that you may remember from the 90s, Placebo, does use it. And the entire team uses it. So if a free piece of software is good enough for international touring with this kind of rock stars, then it's probably good enough for us, right? Okay, one more platform consideration is the iPad option. The only app that I know of currently is called Transfer Function from Studio 6 Digital. You can get that over at studio6digital.com. Again, I don't have much experience with it, but I have had some students who have used it and say that it works great. Okay, so we've got our four options here for audio analyzer setups. We've got Mac, PC, free, and iPad. So we're almost done building our audio analyzer in the shopping portion here, but I have one more thing to show you. So right after this, I'm gonna do another short video. I have built a little chatbot that is going to just walk you through a checklist and help you pick the software if you're still having a little bit of trouble picking software, because I know you have several options here. So I think I can make it even more clear with that. So I'll see you in the next video.
Sound design. Live.